Greetings. This is the second video in the series of an accounting system using Excel. This video is a continuation of the previous one, so please make sure you have watched it before proceeding with this one. In this video, we will create the chart of accounts sheet, which is a crucial component of any accounting system. Let's get started. Here we can see a sample of some accounts and their opening balances. These accounts are all part of the balance sheet and I will adjust them in the chart of accounts worksheet, prior to recording the transactions that occurred during the year. First, I need an account name. Then opening balance. Copy these items from Word to Excel. For debit balances, I used negative numbers and for credit balances, I used positive numbers. This helps to distinguish between the two types of balances. Always use accounting format for numbers to clarify the reports. Wrap text for titles. Bold text. Increase the font size. Center alignment. Choose bottom borders. I will choose blue color for the borders. To ensure that I put correct numbers for accounts, I can see the sum of these numbers in the status bar. The result must be 0. Select this range, the result is 0. I don't need total. After opening balance, I need the financial statement in which the account will be displayed. Let me get the lists I created before in the index worksheet. I will cut them. Paste them here temporarily. I will return them to the index worksheet after finishing. To put the statement correctly, I need data validation. Data tab. Data validation. List. The list I want is H1, J1 range, which contains a balance sheet, an income statement, and a retained earnings statement. All accounts I have here are balance sheet accounts. I can type balance sheet, or simply, fill series. After the statement, I need the category for each account. Format painter. Middle and center alignment for all titles. Here I need depending lists. I explained it before. The simplest way is using XLOOKUP function. Equals. XLOOKUP. Lookup value is C2. Lookup array is H1, J1 range, with absolute reference. Return array is H2, J4 range, also with absolute reference. The result is assets, liabilities, and equity because the statement here is balance sheet. To use this formula in data validation to column D, I will replace C2 with C1. Don't worry about the error, it will work properly in the data validation. Select all formula and cut it. Select column D. Data validation from data tab. List. Paste it in the source field. The list is dependent now. It will change depend on the statement. Let me now fill these cells. Cash is an asset. Accounts receivable, assets. Equipment. Accumulated depreciation, franchises, and accumulated amortization are assets. Accounts payable, liabilities. Common stock and retained earnings are equity. Inventories, assets. Now I want subcategory for each account. In the same way, I need XLOOKUP function for data validation. Lookup value is D2. Lookup array is L1, P1 range with absolute reference. Return array is L2, P6 range with absolute reference. The result here depends on assets. To use this formula in data validation to Colony, I will replace D2 with D1. Cut the formula after selecting it. And as I did before, select Colony and paste the formula in source field of the data validation box after selecting list. Let me fill these cells. Cash, current assets. Accounts receivable, current assets. Equipment, property, plant, and equipment. Accumulated depreciation, property, plant, and equipment. Franchises, intangible assets. Accumulated amortization, intangible assets. Accounts payable, current liabilities. Common stock, paid in capital. Retained earnings, retained earnings. Inventories, current assets. I need a field to arrange cash flow statement. The cash flows categories are just operating, investing, and financing. I made videos that I explained preparation of financial statements. You can find them in the description. For column F, I need data validation. The list I want is K2, K4 range. As you know, the cash appears at the end of the statement. It's not a part of any category. Accounts receivable, operating. Equipment, investing. Accumulated depreciation, operating. This is a transgression because I would consider it as a substitute for the depreciation expense. Franchises, investing. Accumulated amortization, operating. Accounts payable, operating. Common stock, financing. Retained earnings account is not a part of cash flow statement. Inventories, operating. I do not want these lists to remain on this worksheet after I have finished them. I will cut this range. Turn to index worksheet and paste it here. Data validation will not be affected by the cut and paste process. Currently, I have finished the basic information that I have to enter in the chart of accounts worksheet, and the rest of the information will be displayed automatically by equations and formulas after preparing the journal entries worksheet. In the next video, I will review with you the journal entries worksheet while completing the previous example through the commercial transactions that occurred during the year. Remember that the members of this channel have early access to this series and other exclusive benefits. I hope to see you soon in the next video.